God, by your grace.
Lord, have mercy.
Remembering our most holy, pure, blessed, and glorious Lady, the Theotokos and the Virgin Mary, with all the saints, let us commit ourselves and one another and our whole life to Christ our God. Lord our God, whose power is beyond compare and glory is beyond understanding, whose mercy is boundless and love for us ineffable, look upon us and upon this holy school in your compassion. Grant to us and those who pray with us your abundant mercy. For to you belong all glory, honor, and worship, to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and forever, and in the ages of ages.
Bless the Lord, O my soul, and everything within me, bless his holy name. Through the intercessions of the Theotokos, Savior, save us. Bless the Lord, O my soul, and forget not all his rewards. Through the intercessions of the Theotokos, Savior, save us. The Lord prepared his throne in heaven, and his kingdom rules over all. Through the intercessions of the Theotokos, Savior, save us.
Again and again in peace, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
Help us, save us, have mercy upon us, and protect us, O God, by your grace.
Lord, have mercy.
Remembering our most holy, pure, blessed, and glorious Lady, the Theotokos, and the Virgin Mary, with all the saints, let us give ourselves and one another and our whole life to Christ our God.
To thee, O Lord.
Lord God, save your people and bless your inheritance, protect the whole body of your church, sanctify those who love the beauty of your house, glorify them in return for your divine power, do not forsake us with hope in you. For yours is the dominion, the kingdom, the power, and the glory of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, now and forever, and to the ages of ages.
Amen. Praise the Lord, O my soul. I shall praise the Lord while I live. I shall sing to my God as long as I exist. Save us, O Son of God, who are wondrous in the saints. We sing to you, Alleluia. Blessed is he whose help is the God of Jacob. His hope is in the Lord, his God. Save us, O Son of God, who are righteous and the saints. We sing to you, Alleluia. The Lord shall reign forever, your God, O Zion, through all generations. Save us, O Son of God, who are wondrous in the saints. We sing to you, Alleluia. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. Now and forever, unto ages of ages. Amen. Only begotten Son and Word of God, you are salvation condescended to become incarnate of the Holy Theotokos and ever Virgin Mary, and without change became man, and was crucified on Christ our God, and trampled on death by death. Being one of the Holy Trinity, glorified together with the Father and the Holy Spirit, save us.
Again and again in peace, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
Help us, save us, have mercy upon us, and protect us, O God, by your grace.
Lord, have mercy.
Remembering our most holy, pure, blessed, and glorious Lady, the Theotokos and the Virgin Mary, with all the saints, let us commit ourselves and one another and our whole life to Christ our God. Lord, you have given us grace to offer these common prayers with one heart. You have promised to grant the requests of two or three gathered in your name. Fulfill now the petitions of your servants for our benefit, giving us knowledge of your truth in this world, and brightness of the light in the world to come. For you are a good and loving God, and to you we ascribe glory, to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and forever, and ages of ages. The Son of Celebria, the guardian of Elena, and the ardent lover of virtue, who in recent years has appeared, the God-inspired servant of Christ, Micaiah, soul of faithfulness praise, for he gushes forth healings of every kind. To those who cry out reverently, glory to Christ who glorified you, glory to him for your miracles, glory to him who through you effects cures Master and Lord our God, you have established in heaven the orders and hosts of angels and archangels to minister to your glory. Grant that the holy angels may enter with us, that together we may serve and glorify your goodness. For to you belong all glory, honor, and worship, to the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, now and ever, and to the ages of ages. Amen. Blessed is the entrance of your saints, now and ever, to the ages of ages. Amen.
Oh.
Holy One shall boast in glory, and they shall greatly rejoice on their beds.
Let us attend.
Sing to the Lord a new song, his praise in the assembly of his holy ones.
There's home.
The reading is from Paul's letter to the Ephesians.
Let us begin.
Brethren, walk as children of light, for the fruit of light is found in all that is good and right and true, and try to learn what is pleasing to the Lord. Take no part in the unfruitful works of darkness, but instead expose them. For it is a shame even to speak of the things that they do in secret. But when anything is exposed by the light, it becomes visible. For anything that becomes visible is light. Therefore it is said, awake, O sleeper, and arise from the dead, and Christ shall give you light. Look carefully then how you walk, not as unwise men, but as wise, making the most of the time, because the days are evil. Therefore do not be foolish, but understand what the will of the Lord is. And do not get drunk with wine, for that is debauchery. But be filled with the Spirit, addressing one another in psalms and hymns and spiritual songs. Singing and make melody to the Lord with all your heart.
Peace be unto you who read.
Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia.
Wisdom arise, let us hear the Holy Gospel. Peace be unto all.
And with your Spirit.
The Holy Gospel according to John, let us be attentive.
Glory to you, Lord, glory to you.
The Lord said, I am the door. If anyone enters by me, he will be saved, and will go in and out and find pasture. The thief comes only to steal and kill and destroy. I came that they may have life and have it abundantly. I am the good shepherd. The good shepherd lays down his life for the sheep. He who is a hireling and not a shepherd, whose own the sheep are not, sees the wolf coming and leaves the sheep and flees, and the wolf snatches them and scatters them. He flees because he is a hireling and cares nothing for the sheep. I am the good shepherd. I know my own, and my own know me, as the Father's know me, and I know the Father. And I lay my life down for the sheep. And I have other sheep that are not of this fold. I must bring them also, and they will heed my voice. So there shall be one flock, and one shepherd.
Glory to you, O Lord, glory to you.
And grant that always guided by your power, we may give glory to you, to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and forever, and to the ages of ages.
Amen.
Thank you.
Lord our God, remember us all in his kingdom, now and forever, and to the ages of ages.
Amen. Invisibly escorted, escorted by the angelic host.
Complete our prayer to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy. Lord,
have mercy. Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. Help us, save us, have mercy upon us, and protect us, O God. For a perfect, holy, peaceful, and sinless day, let us ask for the Lord. For an angel of peace, a faithful guide, a guardian of our souls and bodies, let us ask the Lord. For forgiveness and remission of our sins and transgressions, let us ask the Lord. All that is good and beneficial to our souls and for peace in the world, let us ask the Lord. For the completion of our life and peace and repentance, let us ask the Lord. For Christian and for life, peace for without shame and suffering, and for a good account of the awesome judgment seat of Christ, let us ask. Remembering our most holy, poor, blessed, and glorious Lady, the pale, hopeless, and ever Virgin Mary, with all the saints, let us commit ourselves and one another and our whole life to Christ our God. Lord God Almighty, you alone are holy. You accept the sacrifice of praise from those who call upon you with their whole heart. Receive also the prayer of the sinners and let it reach your holy altar. Enable us to bring before you gifts and spiritual sacrifices for our sins and for the transgressions of the people. Make us worthy to find grace in your presence, so that our sacrifice may be pleasing to you, and that your good and gracious Spirit may abide with us, with the gifts here presented, and with all your people. Through the mercies of your only begotten Son, with whom you are blessed, together with your all-full good and life-giving Spirit, now and forever, and to the ages of ages.
Amen.
Peace be unto all.
And with your Spirit.
Let us love one another, that with one mind we may confess.
Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, Trinity and Godness, and inseparable.
Guard the doors, wisdom, let us be attentive.
I believe in one God, Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth, and all things visible and invisible, and in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, begotten of the Father before all ages, light of light, true God of true God, begotten, not created, of one essence with the Father, of whom all things were made, who for us men and for our salvation came down from heaven, and was incarnate of the Holy Spirit, and the Virgin Mary became man. He was crucified for us under Pontius Pilate, and suffered and was buried. And he arose on the third day according to the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and sits at the right hand of the Father. And he shall come again with glory to judge the living and the dead, whose kingdom shall have no end. And in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father, who together with the Father and the Son is worshipped and glorified, who spoke through the prophets, and in one holy Catholic and apostolic church, I confess one baptism for the remission of sins. I hope for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the ages to come. Amen.
Let us stand well, let us stand in awe, let us be attentive, that we may present the holy offering in peace.
Mercy and peace.
sacrifice of praise.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God the Father, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with all.
And with your spirit.
Let us lift up our hearts. Spirit, you brought us into being out of nothing, and when we fell, you raised us up again. You did not cease doing everything until you led us to heaven and granted us your kingdom to come. For all these things we thank you and your only begotten Son and your Holy Spirit, for all things that we know and do not know, for blessings seen and unseen that have been bestowed upon us. We also thank you for this liturgy which we are pleased to accept from our hands. Even though we are surrounded by thousands of archangels and tens and thousands of angels, by the cherubim and seraphim, six-winged and eyed and soaring through us. Singing the victory hymn, proclaiming, crying out, and saying, once again, we offer you the spiritual worship without the shedding of blood, and we ask, pray, and entreat you. Send down your Holy Spirit upon us and upon these gifts here presented, and make this bread the precious body of your Christ.
Amen.
And that which is in this cup, the precious blood of your Christ.
Amen.
Changing them by your Holy Spirit.
Amen.
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 Without permission, you gave birth to God the Lord.
and grant that with one voice and one heart we may glorify and praise your most honored and majestic name. Above all, Lord, remember our Bishop Gregory, our Archbishop Salvas, all Orthodox hierarchs, grant that they may serve your holy churches in peace. Keep them safe, honorable, and healthy for many years, rightly teaching the word of your truth. Remember also, Lord, those whom each of us calls to mind, and all your people. And grant that with one voice and one heart we may glorify and praise your most honored and majestic name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, now and forever, into the ages of ages.
Amen.
The mercy of our great God and Savior Jesus Christ be with all.
And with your spirit.
Having remembered all the saints, let us again in peace pray to the Lord. For the precious gifts offered and consecrated, let us pray to the Lord. That our living God, who has received them at his holy, heavenly, and spiritual altar as an offering of spiritual fragrance, may in return sin upon his divine grace and the gift of the Holy Spirit, let us pray. Having prayed for the unity of the faith and for the communion of the Holy Spirit, let us commit ourselves and one another and our whole life to Christ our Lord. We entrust to you, loving Master, our whole life and hope, and we ask, pray, and entreat you. Make us worthy to partake of your heavenly and awesome mysteries from this holy and spiritual table with a clear conscience, the remission of sins, forgiveness of transgressions, communion of the Holy Spirit, inheritance of the kingdom of heaven, confidence before you, and not in judgment or condemnation. And make us worthy, Master, with confidence and without fear of condemnation, we dare call you the heavenly God, Father, and to say,
Father, who art in heaven, thy will be done, thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from the evil one.
For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, now and forever, and for the ages of ages. Peace be unto all.
And with your spirit.
Let us bow our heads to the Lord. We give thanks to you, invisible King, by your infinite power you've created all things, and by your great mercy you brought everything from nothing into being. Master, look down from heaven upon those who have bowed their heads before you. They have not bowed before flesh and blood, but before you, the awesome God. Therefore, Master, guide the course of our life for our benefit according to the need of each of us. Sail with those who sail, travel with those who travel, and heal the sick for the position of our souls and minds. By the grace, mercy, and love for us of your only begotten Son, with whom you are blessed, together with your all holy and life-giving Spirit, now and forever, and to the ages of ages.
Condemnation, for the way they hear your mystery.
with forgiveness of sins, for the life eternal. Amen. How shall I, who am unworthy, enter into the splendor of your saints? If I dare to enter into the bridal chamber, my clothing will accuse me, since it is not of my garment. And being bound up, I shall be cast out by the angels. In your love, Lord, cleanse my soul and save me. Beloved Master, Lord Jesus Christ, my God, let not these holy gifts be to my condemnation, because of my unworthiness, but for the cleansing and sanctification of the soul of God, and the pleasure of the future of my kingdom. It is good for me to cling to God, and to place in him the hope of my salvation. Receive me today, Son of God, as a partaker of your mystical supper. I will not reveal your mystery to your adversaries, nor will I give you a kiss as the Judas, but as a thief I confess to you, Lord, remember me in your kingdom.
Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia.
us be attentive, having partaken of the divine, holy, pure, immortal, heavenly life, giving and awesome mysteries of Christ, let us worthily give thanks unto the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
Help us, save us, have mercy upon us, and protect us, O God, by your grace.
Lord, have mercy.
Having prayed for a perfect, holy, peaceful, and sinless day, let us commit ourselves and one another and our whole life to Christ our God.
To you, Lord.
We thank you, loving Master, benefactor of our souls, that on this day you have made us worthy once again of your heavenly and immortal mysteries. Direct our ways in the right path, establish us firmly in your fear, guard our lives and make our endeavors safe. Through the prayers and supplications of the glorious Theotokos and of the Virgin Mary and of all your saints. For you are our sanctification, and to you we ascribe glory, to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and forever, and in the ages of ages.
Amen.
Let us go forth in peace. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, bless those who praise you, and sanctify those who trust in you. Save your people and bless your inheritance. Protect the whole body of your church. Sanctify those who love the beauty of your house. Glorify them in return by your divine power, and do not forsake us of hoping. Grant peace to your world, to your churches, to the clergy, to those in public service, to the armed forces, and to all your people. For every good and perfect gift is from above, coming from you, the Father of lights. To you we give glory, thanksgiving, and worship to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and forever, and in the ages of ages.
Amen.
Intercessions of his all pure and all immaculate Holy Mother, the power of the precious life-giving cross, the protection of the honorable bodiless powers of heaven, the supplications of the honorable glorious prophet and forerunner John the Baptist, the holy glorious praise of the apostles, the holy glorious triumphant martyrs, our righteous and God-knowing fathers, of the Holy Trinity, whose name they who is the patron saint of our school, the holy righteous ancestors of God Joachim and Anna, our father among the saints, Nectarios, Metropolitan of Pentapolis, the wonder worker whose memory we celebrate today, and of all the saints, have mercy on us and save us, for he is a good God who loves mankind. Through the prayers of our holy fathers, Lord Jesus Christ, our God, have mercy upon us and save us.
Amen.
And the grace of the Holy Trinity be with you this day and always. Thank you so much. You were so attentive, I could tell. And what a blessing for us to be able to start the day with the divine liturgy right here at school.
Father, can I say a few words before we dismiss?
Please.
Could you say something?
Yeah, well, that's what I was getting to. Today is the feast day of St. Nectarios, which is one of Mrs. Gentis's favorite saints. And Father, are you able to talk a little bit about St. Nectarios, please? And I got to go to Greece. When I went to Greece, I went to his church. Into his tomb, and ever since that day, St. Nectarios has just had a special place in my heart. So let's listen to his story.
Okay. Thank you. So on certain days of the year, the church, or really every day, the church celebrates the life of someone who we consider to be a saint, right? Now, who can tell me what a saint is? Bring anyone up first. Nicholas.
Like a martyr, like someone that was very nice that got killed.
A saint could be a martyr, somebody who gave his life for the faith. I saw a hand over here. Who was it? Yes.
A martyr is somebody who loved Jesus, and they died from a bad group of people.
important that they love Jesus and died at the hands of some people who don't. Yes? What other kinds of saints are there?
There's a saint that loves his, that loves God so much he commits his whole life to it.
Perfect. All right, now that's what I want to focus on here. A saint is someone who loves God so much he commits his whole life. Now, Saint Nectarios is an example of somebody who committed his whole life to God. Now, icons of the saints tell us a little bit about their lives. Just looking at the way he's dressed, what can you tell about him? Yes?
He's a priest.
He's a priest. Not only was he a priest, he was a bishop. And so when you see somebody holding a gospel book in an icon, that means they're a bishop, because they were given the charisma, the gift of the Holy Spirit to preach the gospel to us and enlighten us all, even as priests. What's this on his head? What does that show you? What does that mean he was? Yes?
He's holy.
He's got the halo around his head. That's how we show somebody was holy. Yes?
The black thing on his head means he's not married.
The black thing on his, perfect. The black thing on his head means he's not married. So that means he's somebody who did not marry because he wanted to devote his whole life to Christ. Usually people who do that are called, yes?
Monks.
And so he was a monastic. So Saint Nectarios was born in 1846, and he left the earth, this earthly journey, in 1920. In that time, he was a monastic, he was a priest for a while, then he became a bishop, he was a bishop in Egypt, of all places, and then he, yes, see? He was a bishop in Egypt, and then he went to a school. He was a principal. Just as like Mrs. Gentis is the principal of this school, he was a principal of a school for priests. And so he was a principal there for a long time. He built a monastery for women, and he finally left the church in 1920. Now, a lot of times when we see an icon of saints, we think, well, gee, they lived hundreds of years ago. What does that have to do with me? You know, I live in the 21st century. Well, Saint Nectarios, because he lived in the 20th century, we actually have pictures of him. This is an actual picture of Saint Nectarios. And so, if you can tell, he died in 1920, so it's a very old picture, and it's been colorized a while. So they didn't have color photography back then, of course, but this is what he looked like in real life. So you can kind of see there's kind of a resemblance. So the people, when they're depicted in icons, you can see a little bit of a resemblance. It tells you something about their lives, but it also tells you something more important, because it doesn't look like a picture, does it? The icon looks a little bit different. It looks kind of like what you see up here. It looks kind of like Jesus. Jesus's icon. So that tells you this is what we're going to look like, perhaps, when Jesus comes back again. These are going to be our brand new bodies, our glorified bodies, after he comes back from the dead, or after he comes back again and raises us all from the dead. So what is the important thing that people like St. Nectarios show us? It is that we can be a saint in any day or age. You can be a saint. In fact, there are many saints walking around here right now we have no idea about, because they very quietly go about committing their whole life to Jesus Christ. And that's why coming to church and saying prayers and reading the Bible, all those things help us stay focused. It's very easy for us to get distracted. Who gets distracted when you do your homework? Yeah, tell me about it. I get distracted too. When I'm writing sermons, I get distracted. So it happens to everybody. So all these things that the church gives us help us to stay focused on Christ so we don't get distracted. Yes, I've heard some, I see some hands. Go ahead.
When I grow up, I learned that you could get engaged to somebody, but I'm going to never get married. I'm going to serve God.
God bless you from your words to God's ear, and may He always bless you. Now, as you go on through life, you keep praying to Him so that He can guide you to make sure that you're doing what He wants you to do. God bless you. Yes?
Okay, it's the heart.
Yes, Jesus felt a lot of pain for us. So that's a good thing to remember. When you ever feel pain, when you're scared, when you're angry, when you're hurt, your feelings are hurt, when you feel bad about yourself, believe me, Jesus knows just how you feel. Because when he was on the cross, let me tell you, he hurt real bad.
And no, didn't St. Nectarios have a lot of those experiences?
St. Nectarios, let me tell you about something about him. He was somebody who wrestled with cancer. St. Nectarios had cancer, prostate cancer, and that's what finally ended his life. So he is a very active saint. Nobody dies when we're followers of Jesus Christ. We live forever. So he's still helpful for those who are wrestling with cancer. If you know somebody who's wrestling with cancer, you can pray to St. Nectarios to say, hey, help my friend who's wrestling with cancer, and he'll pray for them too. And you'll see, God will send his comfort to that person. Because if one thing St. Nectarios understands, it's illness. So he's somebody that we can all ask. How does that work? If I was sick and I asked you guys to say a prayer for me, would you say a prayer for me?
Yes.
Okay. So, because St. Nectarios is still alive in Christ, we can say, hey, this person, he's sick with cancer. St. Nectarios, say a prayer for him, and he'll do it for you. The help comes from Christ. The prayers come from St. Nectarios. Yes.
What does that mean? Like that one word you said.
Okay, what word was that? Can you give me a...
Cancer?
Uh-huh.
Cancer is when you get really sick. Cancer is a kind of sickness. You like a head cold is a kind of sickness. The flu, like a stomach flu, is a kind of sickness. Cancer is a different kind of sickness, and it's usually something inside that gets sick. Yeah, it can be very serious. And so again, you can pray to somebody like St. Nectarios, and he'll pray to God, and God will send that comfort to that person. Are we still there on time, or are we still about time?
Yeah.
Okay. I'm going to have one more question. Somebody who I have not. Yes.
I'm
going
to be a nun someday.
God bless you. For anybody who wants to devote their life to Christ, just remember, you can be a nun, you can be a monk, but you can also be a married person. Everybody can be devoted to Jesus Christ in their life. And so all we have to do is just say, hey, God, help me figure that out. And he'll help you figure out what's best for you so that you can devote your life to him. And your life can be an expression of his glory. Thank you so much, children. It was an absolute joy.
Father, thank you so much. We enjoyed having you here. Does anybody know who Father Joseph is married to? there's the daughter Melanie. Yes. Thank you, Father. Such a blessing.